Oh my god, we gotta go.
Hey, it's Lauren on Hot 97.5, back with Matt out at Fort Abraham Lincoln, getting ready for the haunted fort, and we are touring some of the buildings out here. Right now, in my opinion, the creepiest spot, we're in the Custer House.
Yeah, this is the gem of Haunted Fort. You know, every year we try to kind of make it spookier, but I always kind of come back to the fact that it's spooky as it is.
You don't really need a lot.
You know, I've always stood by the fact that, you know, we do a bunch of decorating and making Haunted Fort, but just sending like someone in here by themselves and making them walk through the house would probably be the ultimate like haunted tour.
I totally agree.
You know, wouldn't you?
Yes.
I mean,
yes.
It would just be creepy. But yes, I mean the haunted house, the Custer House is kind of that one iconic paranormal myth and legend that's kind of stood the years that it's been reconstructed.
Right, yeah. Growing up in Bismarck, that's what I heard about, was the hauntings here.
Yes. But you know, when we've done some paranormal investigating out here with professional teams, we've, you know, a lot of the voices have come from this main floor corridor, and particularly this room here.
Good.
So if you ever go on the, and we'll feature it on our Haunted Fort page like we do every year, but the EVP sound audio clips from that investigation. One of them, obviously here, talks, the voices of two little girls playing here. So that just kind of sends the chills down your skin, doesn't it, when you talk about that? So, but I'm gonna take you through a couple other rooms,
right,
and we'll talk about some of the little things that have happened in other rooms here in the house.
Okay, let's do it. So we are in the kitchen of the Custer House. So what stuff goes on in here?
So, you know, being in the house, some of the staff and interpreters here, you know, this is kind of the farthest back portion of the house. There's not a lot of visual connection from the front to the back. And so you either way up front in the parlor and hear sounds coming from back here. A lot of them are whisper speaking type of sounds. And some of them actually come from our cellar down here. And now the cellar here is the actual cellar of the house. It was excavated when this house was rebuilt. And so we have a lot of that connection from there as well. So when some of the paranormal investigating was done here in this house, a couple of the voices came when we were talking about the Custer's servant, Miss Mary. It really seemed to bring up a lot of the voices in the audio about her and her life here. Because she spent a lot of time here cooking for the Custers when they lived here at the time. So, so maybe that's some of the reasoning behind it. Not really sure too much as to why this was centralized here, but it was probably a very busy area in the house all day long.
Right.
As they were preparing meals and bringing in food, and as soldiers are bringing in wood and keeping the wood stove here going, all those things would have added to the kind of the activity of this room.
Okay. Well, yeah, I'm definitely getting a creepy vibe. It's very authentic and very...
It is, yes.
Very real. It's, we have a few other places we're going to look at.
Yeah, we could actually head upstairs and check out the upstairs a little
bit. Okay, so I actually feel the most nervous in this room because this is... So the upstairs, the billiard room.
Yes.
Right, and a lot of things happen in here.
Yes, this room tends to be the one room where we experience most of the sounds and kind of visual ghosts of presence, basically. You know, when the house was reconstructed back in 1989, the contractors spoke a few times when they came out to start work on the house that they saw a figured kind of shadowy woman standing in the second level. And a lot of times it was just the framing. The floors weren't even in yet, so there was no possible way that someone would be up there. But they reported seeing this shadowy figure standing up on the second level. Now, we don't know who this person is. It obviously was some woman that I don't believe Mrs. Custer, but some woman that is left behind for some reason. Well, as the years have progressed, our interpreters many times over the years have seen this woman figure looking out this window right here.
This window.
This window, the one we're sitting by.
Oh, perfect.
looking out this window over the grounds in the morning hours. And so, you know, because I don't know why in the morning, they never reported it later on the day or in the evening, but in those morning hours, that figure looking out over the parade ground. So with that in itself, it's already a good story.
Yes.
a good legend for the house here. But, you know, we have a billiards table here.
Yes.
And everyone's heard a rack of billiard balls getting broken open.
Okay.
We've all been to the pool halls and
right.
pool table. And so some of our interpreters in past years have heard when they're downstairs the balls hitting each other up here.
Okay.
Or it's set up as if it's a game's ready to be played, and later on in the day they would come up and the balls have been spread out on the table.
Interesting.
So very interesting, very kind of creepy as to why the fact that this table itself has that type of activity to it, but also great legend right here.
It really is.
So that's our final visit here in the house. I mean, it is creepy, and like I said, you know, even without any props, any music, any lights, it would be hard to get someone to walk through this house by themselves.
I would
in the dark, with no flashlight, no nothing, I think people would freak out.
I totally agree.